This is a presentation on strategy and global competitive environment. I am Joshua Adalami Kassem. I'll be discussing digitization and automobile, the UK automobile industry. In what I'll be covering is the industry scope, industry trend, theoretical framework, as well as scenario grid. The UK is home to prestigious automobile brands such as Land Rover, Aston Martin, Jaguar, and all others. Although as at present, some of these brands are being pretended over by foreign companies. However, they are based in the UK and then they make their operations and production within the UK. This industry, as it is as at today, directly employs over 180,000 persons in its manufacturing and assembling lines, with the industry-wide going to over 864,000 persons in industry-wide. And this accounts to 13% of UK export, which is worth $44.4 billion as of 2018. The UK is known for its strong traditional focus on premium luxury cars. And when we look at premium luxury cars today, we look at Jaguar, we look at Aston Martin, we look at Bentley and Rolls-Royce. All of them operate within the UK business scope. So all of them operate within the UK. A snapshot of the industry as a whole is that we have seven major premium manufacturers of sport cars within the UK. We have five design centers, we have eight bus and coach manufacturers, we have four commercial bus manufacturers, we have 11 engine manufacturers, and these are the statistics that operate within the UK. So it shows the UK is a buoyant market that is ready to promote the automobile industry with research and development centers all over. The major trend in the industry as it were today is that we have autonomous, the quest for autonomous driving, the quest for electric mobility. Everybody don't want carbon emission. We are looking at carbon emission. We no longer need carbon emission. So the drive is geared towards electric vehicle, connected mobility, and shared mobility, which is connectivity as well. Those are the major trends driving the industry as at present. And this industry has key disruptors. Things that are actually disrupting the operation of this industry is the fact that, first of all, there's uncertainty. The future is not certain. So if the future is not certain, the thing that will work all around is the fact that technology is a great disruptor. Today we have a particular brand, and by tomorrow we get a better technology that will outsmart the other one. Look at globalization is the key disruptor as well in this industry. And then the changing values, the values of customers continue to change. So these are the disruptors in the industry. And then the key uncertainties in the automotive industry globally is the fact that price of vehicles and its components is something that is actually uncertain. Government policies cannot be trusted, cannot be so stable. We have consumer trend as an uncertainty, technology adaptation, population growth, economic growth, and savings level. All these things are the key uncertainties that affect the automobile industry. However, the uncertainty of the future regulations and customer acceptance of new technology further compound the issues, because you cannot predict if you bring in a technology today, will customer accept the technology? It's also an uncertain part to trade. The key theoretical framework I'll be discussing is the PERSI framework, which covers the political, the economic, social, technology, legal, and the environment. These are the external environment that affect the operations of the industry in itself. And looking at the political environment, we look at the hard Brexit and the soft Brexit. Which impact will it have on the industry? Whether we go the soft Brexit or the hard one, how will it affect the industry? It goes a long way to determine the success or the failure of the operation of the industry. We have trade restriction. With the coming of Brazil, we expect to have new trade restriction between UK and other, even the EU countries, as it were. We have emission policies and the rest of that, which are under the purview of the political environment. The economic environment is the fact that we are coming out of emerging out of the COVID. the economic business are trying to thrive, investment are trying to pick up and rest. So the impact of the economy goes a long way to affect the operation of every business, not only this industry in particular, because the disposable income have to, of course, increase before we can look at going into a buying of any automobile industry. How much is the interest rate? How much is how is inflation going? These companies come together to affect the industry. Then we look at the popularity. Of course, people want to drive car to show themselves or within their society to be identified with and the rest of it. So that has to do with the social aspect, which is not under the control of the industry as well. Then we look at technology. This industry is driven by technology, and today ICT is playing a key component, a key role in this industry. So if we bring in technology, if we bring in improved ICT and the rest of that, all of them playing their key part, they are going to have a great effect on the industry, which of course the technology, most of the manufacturers have the technology, but with the coming of ICT, which is changing the dimension of the industry right now, is a big issue in this regard. Then we look at the legal aspect, which we look at copyright issues. You create a particular design, a particular product today, you patent it, and all of a sudden it's somewhere else. So if the law backing it is not there, if environmentally focused legislation are not favorable, it's going to affect this operation as well. Then the environment. Today we are looking at carbon emission. We are working towards zero carbon emission. The G7 met and they are looking at zero carbon emission. Globally, the issue of carbon emission has become an issue. So industry have to remodel their plant operations and their facility to work in line with meeting up with this particular dimension. So, and all these items work operate outside the confines of the industry. Then the drivers of the future, we are looking at the future of the automobile industry we are looking at in this particular case. It's been governed by demography, by the economy, by the environment, and then the technology. These are four components that affect this, that drive the future. So if you are looking, you don't produce a product that you don't have a market for. The demography determine, a favorable demography determine the market, the potential of buying the market. If we have the demography, we don't have the economy, the empowering economy. The demography cannot purchase the product. If our product is injurious to the environment, it's going to bring environmental hazard. We are suffering with climate change, so the impact is not going to be well. So these are the drivers, and then we look at technology. Of course, technology is the major force that is driving this industry. So we look at that, and these are the driving force that help the industry to move forward. Scenario creation process is actually not a one direction way. It has multiple influence factors that actually influence a particular scenario. And it's been described with a coin-like face in the sense that it comes narrowly and all of a sudden you get to have different options. But if you are able to, if we see them together, if we're able to put them together, we'll be able to realize our particular goal, which is in the consistent picture we are looking at. We can be able to merge different factors together to be able to arrive at the particular feature or the picture we are looking at in the future, which brings us to the possibility coin, which is the future may not be one. We can have different operation. It can come in the left hand side, it can come in point A, it can be in point B, it can be in point C. So the future is not a one-way thing. It's a possibility that it can come either way. So that is why the possibility coin is very, very strategic in scenario planning. And this is my scenario grid. And the key issue I'm looking at is the adoption of ICT. ICT innovation and technology in the production in the automotive industry, and then the opposing side, which is the stall ICT innovation and then adoption of stall ICT adoption and technology, and then we'll look at an empowering economy and then the disempowering economy. Put this together, I'll be able to bring out the scenario grid. On my scenario one is the fact that ICT giant will take over automobile industry. With the aid of Industry 4.0, it gives anybody that has the automation and the capacity to produce anything to go ahead to produce it. So this gives the ICT, since the drive, the trend is moving towards adoption of ICT, it gives ICT giant opportunity to be able to produce vehicles of their own, meaning that they have the capacity, they will now have the capacity and the technology to be able to put their ICT knowledge together, to put the connectivity together, the mobility together, and then be able to produce their cars. And the few automobile manufacturers that we have as at today, the few that will survive will end up being designers or end up being contract product manufacturers for this ICT giant. That is my scenario one. My scenario two, look at the ICT giant will serve as a suppliers and suppliers as well as and competitors in the industry. And in this particular case, the car manufacturers, of course, their knowledge, their expertise still remain intact. However, we expect ICT companies to now be suppliers of the key component, the new driving component that they will be needing in their production. However, the ICT companies might as well overcome cars manufacturers by producing cars that meet up most especially with the urban setting where they will have, of course, greater edge of their connectivity and the rest of that. The third scenario is that ICT giants are going to serve as suppliers, and then they are going to determine the key product differentiation. They have customer data, which is very relevant, which is very essential. They know the taste of customers. They are, in this particular scenario, the ICT companies are going to be the one to set the differentiation. They are going to be the one to determine the connectivity. They are going to, since their aim is to be able to provide the connectivity that customers need, they'll be the one to determine this differentiation. Why the last one is the ICT giants are going to remain indifferent in the automotive business. All they are there to do is become major suppliers to automobile industry, to the manufacturer. They are going to be there for the manufacturer. However, they are not interested in the business aspect of automobile. So all they are into it is not profitable for them to provide their services, their internet connectivity, their infotainment, the media that is needed in this new technology. All they are interested is that, and is that alone. However, why the ICT provide this efficiency advantage in the manufacturing? The manufacturer go ahead to explore the market, the production, and then the technology to do that. So in the first scenario, we expect that customer expectations, of course, are very high. So if customer expectations are high and data is in the hands of the internet giant, this help them to attain their goals. And this helped them to attain their goals of course, taking over the automobile industry at the end of the day, because customers give them the taste of what they want, and they have the customer at hand, and customer will not want their data to be shared randomly. So they have the control, so they can go ahead to make production. And then the goal of the ICT company is, of course, to eventually overcome the automobile, the manufacturers, and then be able to bring up their own industry. Unfortunately, the original vehicle manufacturer will end up dedicating themselves in designing and then serving providing other contract services to the ICT giant, which means that the ICT will overrun the industry as it were. Then the second scenario is that customers have very high expectation as well. We expect customer expectation to be high when it comes to the efficiency of the connectivity, the efficiency of the mobility and the rest of that. So if the expectation is high and the ICT have their way, their goal of the ICT company here is to become a tier one supplier of the automotive, of the component to manufacturers, and then the manufacturer, especially at the end of the end of owning their own production line. Of course, mostly in the urban, we expect them to have more strength in the urban area. And then the major goals of the company in this scenario is the fact that they have direct access to the passenger. Their goal is to provide the connectivity the passenger needs. So in the semi-autonomous driving, when semi-autonomous driving come into play, for them to provide this connectivity, provide the infotainment to have direct access with their media to customers. Scenario three, look at the giant who now serve as suppliers and key determinant of differentiation. Customer desires for connectivity. The customer want good connectivity, while the market differentiation is driven strictly by the ICT. Vehicle manufacturer focus on cost optimization and standard. The ask is to bring out the standard, bring out optimization, while ICT bring out the connectivity and the driving force which customers will need. ICT firm in this particular scenario will only serve as suppliers, and then because they are making high profit, their interest is not in floating their own cars. At the end of the day, the ICT giant remain indifferent in scenario four. ICT giant remain indifferent in the automotive industry. All they are concerned is they stay away from the business. Their services, they try to bring services that will bring efficiency in the manufacturing of cars. However, going into production is not profitable in this case. So it is more profitable to provide those connectivity, those services, those necessary components that is driving the trend. The needed trend that is driving the industry right now. The ICT are go- their own is to provide those services and then back off for the vehicle, original vehicle manufacturers to continue with their own manufacturing. In this case, they are not being muzzled, manufacturers are not muzzled by ICT with their gadget and then with their influence. Rather, they compete with it themselves. And here is the reference. Thank you very much.